I would have noticed this area if I started in the original aspect, because I could just make out the flashing at the very top of the screen. But in widescreen format, it cuts the top of it off, so yeah.
Thank you. I'll investigate this area a little further.
There you go. Luckily, Chris walks kind of fast.
Rebecca!
I saw you in... Chris!
Rebecca, you're alive!
Yeah.
There's nothing left for us to do here. Let's get moving.
That's a much faster way to do it.
Chris?
Alright, let's be done with this.
The self-destruct system's activated.
Good work! Brad's up in the helicopter! Shit, it's those nasties again.
Chris, if Brad's still up there, please try to get in contact with him.
But...
leave them up to me.
All right. Clean him up.
No problem.
Becca's gonna hold her own. Thank you. you don't. Jill goes up with it.
Tired?
Chris, I'm sorry for...
Rebecca, you did just fine. This case was just too strange. It was just too...
Why is it the good endings that are the most cinematic and have like the most dialogue and whatnot? Alright, well, skipping the credits.
Chris, you did a fine job.
And definitely got under 3 hours. Alright. And I got the rocket launcher. And that's that. There you go. Alrighty, so that was my 8th playthrough. That was Chris's good ending. We got the rocket launcher and whatnot. So, just like in Jill's side of things, I will make Chris's 3rd playthrough the speed run of his side, basically, with the rocket launcher and all. Another thing, so, having unlocked the rocket launcher, now I feel like it's okay to load from Jill's completed game. Upon doing that, when I beat the next playthrough, I will unlock one dangerous zombie mode. So, I will go into more detail in the next playthrough, guys. So, until then, this is Shankster94, aka The Gamer Shankster. Rate, comment, subscribe. Don't forget to follow me on Twitter at Shankster_94. Check out my Facebook page. Support me on Patreon. Shout out to Wyatt Shotrun for being my one and only patron as of this moment. Alrighty, peace out.